इफ यू हैव लिटिल टाइम, ज्यादा टाइम बचा नहीं है एंड यू डेफिनेटली वॉन्ट टू क्लियर द एग्जाम एंड यू आर थिंकिंग यार अब तो नहीं हो पाएगा तो जस्ट लीव इट, नो,
डोंट स्किप द सब्जेक्ट, गो फॉर रैपिड रिविजन इंस्टेड. So today we have with us Dr. Richa on our channel to guide us about how to crack FMG correctly. And if you are an aspirant who has no time or who hasn't prepared enough, then well, you're just on the right video because this is going to help you a lot. If at all you want to watch any topic specifically, I'm going to mention all the timestamps on the Seek below and in the description box. And if you feel that a few questions were not covered or you have any more questions, feel free to DM us on our Instagrams or you can also mention all your questions in the comment section below. So Dr. Richa, welcome to my channel and how are you feeling today?
Very overwhelmed and thank you for having me first of all.
We are so excited to hear about your journey because honestly, FMG is a tough nut to crack. So when it comes to preparing for FMG, 19 subjects, it's a lot.
Yeah.
And the content is way too vast. Earlier, we did not have any apps or something. But these days, you have Marrow, PrepLadder, Unacademy, new apps coming up like Cerebellum, Myst, whatnot. Did you choose an online resource?
Yes.
Definitely. And which one did you choose?
My preference was Marrow.
Okay.
I went with Marrow and I can't comment in any like any other sources because
yeah.
I had only one source. I would stick to that.
Okay. So you did not go for any offline institutions?
No.
Just Marrow. Marrow.
Just Marrow.
Most of the people try experimenting a bit. Like some of them will choose one source for QBanks, one source for videos. Someone will buy notes from some other source. Did you do that or did you just go for videos, QBanks and notes all in one app?
Sticking to one resource is really nice.
Okay.
क्योंकि उससे तुमको ये पता है कि क्वेश्चन का पैटर्न उनका है डिसाइड
yeah.
करने का अगर तुमने उनके नोट से पढ़ा है तो वो सारी चीजें बहुत हेल्प करती है.
Okay. And when it comes to rapid revisions, like these people also have main videos and rapid revision videos. Do you recommend rapid revision videos?
In my personal opinion, rapid revisions are really nice. बहुत अच्छे होते हैं वो. You can take it home like ठीक है मैं ये पढ़ के मैं exam definitely crack कर सकता हूँ.
Okay.
It's not like that कि main videos नहीं हुए. Oh my god, I can't do it. It's
yeah,
definitely doable.
Most of the people have this like image in their mind that rapid revision videos are not enough. And it doesn't work for most of them. But did rapid revisions work for you? And for which subjects did you go for rapid revision?
Rapid revisions are really nice for each and every subject. It's
okay.
None like this ki nahi isme kuch kam hai, isme thoda zyada hai. It's very nice. You can take it as your main source if you have little time, zyada time bacha nahi hai and you definitely want to clear the exam and you're thinking yaar ab to nahi ho payega to just leave it. No.
Don't skip the subject, go for rapid revisions instead.
Instead.
And when you are revising your notes, the most important part is also making them concise. So do you think there's a difference between the actual notes and the rapid revision notes where what Marrow provides?
Revision notes are the ones that is required to crack the exams.
Just to pass it.
Just it's to enough. Pass it. Yeah, it's more than enough. It's not just enough, it's more than enough. Because they provide you the concise part. Jo main lectures hai, usme they will teach you each and everything, the detailed ones. But what is required to clear the exam is
yeah.
bit different.
Yeah.
Hum jo puri book padhte hai, to kuch topics hota hai jo exam mein aate hai.
Exactly.
Baaki is required to build the background
yeah.
for the topics to be understood.
Yeah.
So if you have it, and even if you don't have it, in the revision video it is covered.
If you have to divide the 19 subjects into subjects of top priority or more weightage, moderate weightage and low weightage, how would you divide them?
Firstly, the major chunks comes over the four subjects, as we all know, medicine,
yeah.
surgery, obs, gyne, and PSM.
Yeah, all because, of them have said it.
Yeah, because they have the maximum number of questions,
mm-hmm.
like cross 30.
For each subject.
Yeah, you can take it that way. And then you can come for the under 20s,
okay.
like the 15 marks questions.
Yeah, 15 to 20
questions. 15 to 20 questions, and then 5 marks questions.
So what are the subjects of moderate? Value.
Moderate are like optha, ENT, pediatrics.
Okay.
All these subjects come in the moderate one, and they are really scoring. Like
yeah.
you can score a lot of marks in that.
Okay.
You should strategize the questions for which subject. How much questions are there? You should
yeah.
prioritize in accordingly the subject that way.
Yeah.
Like maybe you can think of skipping ortho.
Yeah.
Anesthesia because the subject's marks are less. It's 5.
Yeah. What was your take on solving Q-banks and especially the grand tests, or some people call it the mock tests?
Mm-hmm.
When did you start giving those examinations, and what is your take on the importance of these Q-banks, solving questions basically?
First of all, everyone thinks like Q-banks and this all is like when you have completed a subject, only then approach it. Otherwise, it will demotivate you. Oh my god, I'm not able to solve, I'm not able to reach a particular mark. Not just 50% is able to be crossed in this.
Yeah.
So maybe it's not right, I can't do it, I'll give up.
Yeah.
People go in anxiety. But
yeah.
Thing is, you should take it as a study material. This is the very big guru mantra you should take. Every teacher tells you this. Like, it's not just the questions, it's the study material, because many topics are not being covered by the teachers itself in the main videos.
Yeah.
It's covered in the questions.
Q-banks. Yeah.
When you solve it, you understand it. Okay, this is the topic. How you need to approach it will come from the questions.
Okay.
Because whatever you study, I will give you my personal example.
Mm-hmm.
I never attempted the questions directly first. I used to think, pehle main padh leti hu pura, fir uske baad main attempt karungi questions.
Mm.
But that was very bad approach.
Yeah.
Because then ऐसा होता है कि तुम्हें यही नहीं पता, मैंने पढ़ा तो है, इसको apply कैसे करूँ यार? मैं कहूँ ना सब पढ़ लिया.
Exactly.
Marks क्यों नहीं score हो रहे, above 50 क्यों नहीं touch हो रहा है? But the thing is, you need to understand the application of the knowledge you have.
Yeah.
So that's why questions are really important.
And mostly the exposure of the type of questions. Because these days I've heard that the questions are getting lengthier,
mm-hmm.
and they are trying to confuse you,
mm-hmm.
but they ask a very basic point from somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
And these apps are really trying their best to involve such questions in their grand tests. So do you feel the questions that you solved appeared in the exams as well?
Yeah, it did. Like, it's not like the topic, it's just the topic that will repeat. Questions will change, but you will know the pattern.
Yeah.
How to solve it, you will know the approach, how to deal with the type of questions. Because in exam, it's not like that. Biochem chal raha hai, biochem ke hi 10 questions aa jayenge. Nahi, abhi tum biochem ka question solve kar rahe ho, suddenly bombard aayega udhar se pdf ke question ka.
Yeah.
Tum biochem se bachchon mein kaise ghus jaoge?
Yeah.
So you need to train your mind to solve
to switch
it.
Subjects.
Yeah, to switch subjects, to go from one isse to the something other wala cheez ekdam se aa gaya hai. Tum biochem soch rahe the abhi.
Yeah. Now I have a slightly tricky question for you, which I am sure many students will relate to. These four subjects, the hero subjects. Agar ye kisi ne padhe hi nahi hai, nobody has studied it, not even touched the subject. And you have 2 to 3 months to prepare. How to prepare those subjects? Do you have any tips or tricks? And did you go through a similar situation?
Yes, definitely. My surgery was pending, my obs gyne was pending. Somehow little bit of PSM was also pending. But then my opinion, as I'm always saying from the starting of this video, it's like it's very much doable with the revision videos.
Okay.
So I was stick to the revision videos. I never changed my sources, nothing else, just the revision videos.
Okay. And what was your exam experience like? And if someone has a set of exams, or like this is a set of two exams, we can say part one, part two. Pehla wala nahi acha gaya. Does it affect your part 2? What is your take on such conditions if someone experiences this?
Over this, it's you need to understand you have done a lot of hard work.
Mm-hmm.
You need to believe in yourself. Ki maine jitna hard work kiya, that was much required. Aur dusri cheez ye hai ki you have an option of a second paper as well.
Exactly.
Agar tumhare paas bas ek hi paper hai, tumhe pata hai ki usme blunder ho gaya, ab to ho gaya.
Hmm.
But if you will take the first paper ka pura stress, pressure, anxiety to the second paper, definitely you will lose it.
Yeah.
You're making a mess for yourself. You got an opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
Ki tumhare paas second paper hai. You can buck up.
Save yourself.
Yeah. You should.
Like, how was your part one? How was your exam?
Yeah. It's a big topic to talk over. Like, paper mein hum chale gaye. So before that, I practiced GTs, this, that, everything. But suddenly in the paper questions, I was like bit of, you can say, confident ki chalo main kar lungi, GTs mein achhe aa rahe hai. This is also a thing you need to control over.
Okay.
So what I did ki, theek hai, thoda alag tarike se solve karte hai.
Which I never did. Exam strategy.
Yeah. Which I never did in my GTs. Never ever. I was like, nahin, main isi se stick hu, main isi se marks nikalti hu, main main paper mein bhi aise hi karungi. But in the exam, I thought questions mele familiar hai, I'm able to do it. चलो ठीक है, लेट्स लिटिल बिट ऑफ चेंज थोड़ा कर सकती हूँ मैं, ऐसा मुझे लगा वहां पे. एंड आई डिड दैट. इन द एंड I was left with 13 questions not solved.
You skipped 13 questions.
Yeah, I wasn't able to attempt it.
In your first part?
In my first part.
And how did you deal with it?
In the exam itself, I was super anxious. I wasn't able to like relax my foot or like anything because you're so anxious, like 60 questions. Like even now I can shiver because I can have the similar feelings as I'm talking over it. Ki 60 questions.
This is scary.
Yeah, I'm shivering, you can't understand it, but it is. So exam day and the preparation phase is completely different.
Okay.
You just can't take it. So it's said like every attempt is very important. As I always say, you should never skip the attempt.
Yeah. And this is a sign that you'll pass it, guys.
Yeah.
So now you have skipped 13 questions. You have to give your part 2. How did you deal with that? How did you go approach part 2?
I came out. Family members hai, friends hai, ye wo wo khade hai. I was just like, I wasn't talking with anyone.
Mm-hmm.
My family was trying to talk something else, like something very else to calm me down because they can see it on my face.
Yeah.
Ki kuch toh ho gaya hai andar. Ab ye bolegi toh nahi. So I just went aside and I just motivated myself. I remembered the time which I dedicated, the 2 months that I paid the hard work, the studies, how my GTs went, how everything. I recalled all of it.
Yeah.
And with that, I gathered the confidence ki nahin, main karungi.
Okay.
I will do it. That was the only thing I did at that moment because no one was there to motivate me. I can't talk with my parents.
Yeah.
I can't speak because it's my thing.
Yeah.
I have to face it.
So, you talked about the 2 months of preparation that you did. What was your dedicated and your pre-dedicated period of preparation specifically for FMG, like a massive exam ke liye pad rahi ho?
Like May ke month mein it was the pre-dedicated part jab tak ke date fix nahi hua tha.
Yeah.
Jis tak sirf yeh tha ki exam hone wala. Initially to baat aise chal rahi thi exam hoga bhi nahi shayad is saal kyunki next aane wala hai.
Next aane wala tha.
Bahut sari cheeze aisi ho gayi thi. To May was the pre-dedicated part. And जब fix हो गया कि भाई अब तो exam होने ही वाला है
date आ गया है
हाँ तो from June it's the proper dedicated वाला time.
Did you divide your study schedule into an hourly manner कि हाँ मैं रोज इतने घंटे मुझे पढ़ना है या you divided it into topic session कि इतने topics cover करने हैं
कैसे होता है जब हम इस जर्नी में आते हैं तो हम पहले तो कंफ्यूज होते हैं कि हम ये करें पहले आवरली पे जाए या पहले इस पे जाए क्योंकि सिटिंग इटसेल्फ इज डिफिकल्ट
या सिटिंग फॉर दैट मेनी आवर्स टुगेदर
हाँ और पढ़ने बैठना ही डिफिकल्ट है क्योंकि तुम इतने चिल्ड हो ना अभी तो एग्जाम शायद नहीं होने वाला है या होने वाला है तो खुद को फिक्स करना है तो यू आर इन द डिलेमा तो इनिशियली इट्स लाइक कि चलो पहले आवर्स बढ़ाते हैं पहले बैठते तो है एटलीस्ट फिर आगे टॉपिक्स का सोचेंगे तो इनिशियली आई वाज लाइक कि ठीक है थोड़ा टाइम लेते हैं बैठते हैं एंड देन आई स्विच टू द टॉपिक्स पार्ट
ओके सो ऑन एन एवरेज इफ यू हैव टू गिव एन आइडिया टू द व्यूअर हाउ मेनी आवर्स ऑन एन एवरेज डिड यू स्टडी इन योर प्री डेडिकेटेड टाइम एंड इन योर डेडिकेटेड टाइम
जैसे मैंने बोला इनिशियली बैठना वाज डिफिकल्ट सो आई वुड हैव सैट फॉर लाइक 1 आवर फॉर द फर्स्ट गो देन धीरे धीरे वो 3 आवर्स में बढ़ते गए एंड देन इन द एंड या इट वाज लाइक 16 आवर्स 16 टू दैट आवर्स
इफ यू टॉक अबाउट सोशल मीडिया इट इज अ बिग डिस्ट्रैक्शन डिड यू क्विट सच एप्स और यू वर मॉडरेटली यूजिंग इट विद सेल्फ कंट्रोल यू नो सम पीपल जस्ट डीएक्टिवेट देयर अकाउंट्स व्हाट इज योर टेक ऑन दैट
मैंने डीएक्टिवेट वगैरह नहीं किया था बट हाँ मैं पहले तो काफी यूज हो रहा है बट फिर धीरे धीरे जब स्ट्रेस बिल्ड हो रहा है कि नहीं अब एग्जाम आने ही वाला है अब फिक्स हो गया तो ऑटोमेटिकली इट वाज अ सीन फॉर मी कि चलो ठीक है मैं कंट्रोल करके अभी इसके जगह पे आई यूज्ड टू स्क्रॉल इमेज बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस
इंस्टेड ऑफ इंस्टाग्राम
यस
सो इमेज बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस जो इंस्टाग्राम की जगह आपने इमेज बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस या क्यूबैंक स्क्रॉल किए वाज इट हेल्पफुल इन योर एग्जाम
डेफिनेटली इट वाज अ लॉट क्योंकि क्वेश्चन सेम आएगा ऐसी कोई गारंटी नहीं होती बट पैटर्न जरूर सेम आएगा उसका कुछ तो ऐसा पार्ट होगा जो सिमिलर आएगा लाइक एग्जाम के एक रात पहले मैंने एक क्वेश्चन सॉल्व किया एंड आई वाज लाइक इट वाज अ बिट ट्रिकी वन सो आई वाज थिंकिंग अ लॉट उस क्वेश्चन के ऊपर मैं जैसे मैंने कुछ सब्जेक्ट छोड़ दिए थे स्पेसिफिकली उन सब्जेक्ट्स के क्वेश्चंस की बात कर रही हूं मैं तो उसको सोचा फिर उसके बाद में एक दो दिन देखा और मेन पेपर में वो क्वेश्चन था
एग्जैक्टली सो इट हेल्प्स
तो इट रियली हेल्प्स
Instagram scrolling might not benefit you, but image-based question scrolling will definitely save your exam day. How did you deal with the pre-exam anxiety?
Pre-exam anxiety, my take-home thing was only thing. This is a do-or-die situation for me. Mm-hmm. Because people take it ki chalo attempt hai. Attempt ke raha se dekhte hai usko. But mujhe wo cheez waisi nahi chahiye thi. Mujhe wo cheez aise chahiye thi ki main agar battery ho na, it should be done.
Yeah. Just in one go, just pass it.
Just pass it. Because the approach what you have from day one towards this exam will take you that way.
Yeah. And when it comes to the result day, what was your reaction? Can you please take us back to your result day?
Okay. जैसे मैंने बताया था तुमको कि क्वेश्चंस छूट गए हैं, फिर लोगों की बातें आ रही है कि अब तो पेपर बहुत डिफिकल्ट है, तो तुम इतने घबराए हुए हो कि क्या होने वाला है तुम्हारे साथ में.
Exactly. And I've seen this trait that every time the FMG result is preponed. ये डेट अलग देते हैं, रिजल्ट आता अलग दिन पे.
Exactly. और इस बार ऐसा बिल्कुल भी नहीं हुआ. हम लोगों को पूरा प्रॉपरली वेट करना पड़ा है एंड तक कि तभी रिजल्ट मिलेगा, उस टाइम पे आएगा. तो हम लोग आराम से बैठ के खाना वाना खा रहे हैं, उतने में सडनली न्यूज आ रही है कि यार अभी रिजल्ट आने वाले आ गया है करके. एंड फिर एक दिन पहले मेरी एक फ्रेंड से बात हुई थी, इट वाज लाइक कि मैं रिजल्ट देख, मैं खाना खा रहा था, रिजल्ट आया, मैं फेल हो गया. वो फीलिंग मुझे आ गई उस टाइम पे कि यार मैं भी सेम फेज में हूं.
एंड यू वर आल्सो ईटिंग फूड.
या सो बट ठीक है, व्हेन आई वेंट की पीडीएफ आ गया है, सो फटाफट सर्च किया. मैंने लिटरली अपने मार्क्स भी नहीं देखे, बस नाम के एंड में जाके PAS. आई एम जंपिंग, पूरे घर में कूद रही थी मैं कि हो गया.
एंड आई होप दैट एवरी व्यूअर आल्सो जंप्स विद जॉय वंस दे क्लियर दिस एग्जामिनेशन. बट इज इट पॉसिबल टू पास इन द फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट? व्हाट इज योर मैसेज टू समवन हु इज डाउटिंग कि मैं पास होऊंगा कि नहीं?
फॉर मी आई विल टेल यू, मे एंड में ऐसा था कि पेपर होने वाला है. That time I used to think, यार जो लोग पास करते हैं उनके तो एकदम टिप्स पे होती है चीजें. मुझे तो अभी मेजर चंक ऑफ सब्जेक्ट्स करने हैं, दैट इज गाइनी, सर्जरी, हाउ विल आई मेक इट. दैट वाज अ डाउटिंग फेज ऑफ मी, बट आई टुक इट इन अ पॉजिटिव वे कि नहीं मुझे करना ही है. आई विल मेक श्योर आई विल डू इट. एंड दैट्स द वे आई वेंट थ्रू इट.
Exactly.
And by the end, you can never be sure कि मेरा पूरा प्रिपरेशन हो गया, definitely I'm going to pass it.
Yeah.
Whatsoever you do it.
Go with पूरे जर्नी में.
Just go with it.
And what is your final message for the students who are afraid of this examination? What do you think are the advantages of having FMGA?
Firstly, इसमें negative marking नहीं है. India के हर exam में negative marking होती है.
Exactly.
इसकी it's pass or fail exam. जैसे मैंने बोला, it's not a scoring exam.
Yeah.
50% वाली चीज है, negative marking नहीं है. It's just a dedicated phase. You have to do it.
Exactly.
कि तुमको बैठना है और खुद के लिए करना है, not for your X Y Z persons.
Yeah.
It's for you. For yourself.
Do you think they'll pass the examination?
Everyone can pass the exam. Everyone.
This is your sign, guys, that you're going to pass this examination. And what I can take from your journey is, agar aapke major subjects baki bhi hai, koi tension matlab ho jayega. Even the minor subjects are possible. Just don't skip on solving questions. Solving questions is the key. Grand tests is the key. And subscribing to my channel is also the key, because you are going to get all such tips constantly from my channel. If you have any other video ideas, if you want us to make another video with some other questions, just DM me on Instagram. She is also on Instagram, by the way. Please follow her channel and you can ask us your queries over there. Till then, don't forget to have your cup of positivity, and thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you so much, Dr. Richa, for all the guidance that you provided. And if they can do it, you can do it too.
Everyone can do it.
Exactly. All the best and have a great exam, guys.